Hello guys, this is Cesar Creates and welcome back to my channel. Today we are finally back in our desert adventure park and we are building a habitat for the greater flamingos. This is like a first regular habitat for this zoo. We've built a capuchin monkey habitat here, but it was more of a part of an entrance actually. It was more like an exhibit inside of the entrance, but now we are creating a first like regular habitat out in the open air, and let me just tell you that I love how it has turned out in the end, so definitely stay tuned because you don't want to miss it. I think that it is actually one of my favorite habitats that I've built so far. I know that I tell this a lot, but I feel like we are getting better and better at building, so yeah, this one is special and I cannot wait for you guys to see it all done in the end because it looks really, really good. We are finally back in the Desert Adventure Park after the while, because lately I've been focusing more on the Elm Hill City Zoo. We've built the desert house in the zoo and I really wanted it to be finished quickly because I was really like hyped for this build. So yeah, I've been uploading videos only from the Elm Hill City Zoo, and now it is time for the Desert Adventure Park finally. We also created a little special project, I mean the Pygmy Hippo Habitat for the Kangathon 2021, which was really fun and something different. In case you haven't seen that video, because I don't think that all of you saw that, definitely go and check it out. I will add the link to this video on the screen and down in the description. And definitely go and check it out because, as I told you, it is something totally different than we did in other zoos. It has like this completely different vibe. I was trying to recreate the habitat from the Kanga Wildlife Ranch, the ranch that we actually helped during the Kangathon. So if you want to see totally different approach to building, totally go and check it out. Yeah, I was actually uploading a lot of videos lately. I was uploading at least 2 times a week, and I told you guys that I would like to stay, stick to that, like uploading 2 times a week, because I saw that it really works for, views and for how many new people showed up to the channel. So thank you for that. Thank you if you're a new subscriber. Definitely, I am super, super grateful for all the new faces. And welcome. Hello. But then, again, I had a lot of things to do at work. I also had a wedding of my friends that I was invited to during last weekend. So, yeah, I couldn't play the game. I couldn't record. So, there was a little break on my channel, but hey, we are back again. We are creating this habitat for the Desert Adventure Park today, and I think that on Saturday we'll be having another video from the Elm Hill City Zoo. This is also something very, very exciting, so don't miss it. I already like build the majority of this habitat and I think that you guys will enjoy it, so definitely stay tuned because I think that this week we'll actually have 2 videos, so it is always very exciting for me to have like more than one because then I know that I am doing it right. So yeah, I try to stick to 2 videos, but most of the times it is hard for me to upload 2 times a week because of, you know, it takes time to record the video, I mean to build, to record the video, then to edit it, to cut out those things that make the video too long, to add the sound, to, you know, record the voiceover, to do the cinematic shots and so on. But I will do my best to upload 2 times a week because I would really love that for this channel. It's not like I'm pushing myself or anything. Because I know that I can do it if I like focus on my schedule and so on. But yeah, I would really love to update 2 times a week, and I will do all like my best to do it. So Please excuse me, guys, if sometimes there's only one video or there's not any videos at all, because sometimes, you know, I have simply a lot of things on my mind. I have a lot of things to do, and sometimes also, like with this habitat, I had really, really hard time to start. It's always so hard for me to start a new zoo because you have this, you know, large, plain, you know, blank canvas, like this map that doesn't have anything on it, and it doesn't have any reference of the size of the scale. So you are really like trying to make the habitat, your first habitat, the right size, like it's just not to make it too small or too large. I was making this one too large all the time, and then I tried to make it smaller and it turned out so tiny that I had to do it again. So yeah, I was trying so hard that actually one time I've like wasted all my evening for like trying to start it, and I recorded nothing. So yeah, it was hard, but in the end, yeah, I was finally able to do it. Maybe I could have made it like further from the entrance, because now it is a bit like close. But besides that, I think that the scale of it, like the size, is just right, and I really like how it has turned out in the end. So let me just tell you a bit about this habitat. I was obviously inspired by the Dubai Safari Park. Like the entrance of this zoo and the whole concept of this zoo was inspired by this particular zoo. So yeah, they have this really nice flamingo habitat. They actually have two flamingo habitats, and this is what we are creating today. So in this zoo, you have these two separate enclosures for birds like flamingos, but they also have some other water birds like flamingos or herons or storks living in those two habitats. Obviously, we don't have them in game, so I only focus on flamingos. I know that there are mods probably of those animals, but maybe I will add them in the future, who knows. Right now I knew that I wanted to have flamingos, and I think that they are like completely enough for those two habitats. In the end, it looks super fine with only flamingos in them. So you have those two separate habitats, and then you have three paths. One is in the middle when you have like the main viewing for the birds that are living in there. And then you have like those two wider paths on the sides that are more like two like broadwalks, like the main, you know, communication in the zoo where people are moving. You can still see those birds, but you know, all the information and all the, you know, this like viewpoint for them is in this middle path. So it is like the dedicated path to go and see the birds that are living in there. And yeah, those two habitats, they're mainly like water areas, and they have some islands for the birds. So this is what I was going for. This episode is called Flamingo Islands because today we are building islands on water for them. So we have in both this like main island where the entrance to the habitat is for the keeper, and then we have two small islands in one of the habitats and one like bigger island in the second one, so that the flamingos can swim or just go in this more shallow water to this island. And you know, they have some enrichment, they have some place to rest on them, so they are using all of those islands. And I really, really like this concept. I think that it looks super, super cool. It was actually the first time I was doing something like this. I mean, obviously I did some islands, but not in habitat that the main focus of it is the islands and the things that are on them. So yeah, I really, really like it. Obviously, the keeper won't be able to go there, like won't be able to go to those islands. So I placed all of the food things and food enrichment on the main islands so that they wouldn't have to go there. Normally they probably would put those, you know, special very high boots made from rubber and go there and to clean it and to put some, you know, food and nutrient for the animals, but here they cannot, so yeah, we had to focus all the food things like on the main islands, and that is what I basically did in here. While I was talking, you also could see me doing the lining for those islands, I mean the lining of the pond. I'm not sure that if the concrete version of it is also called pond liner, but I know that this this special foil for the ponds, like that you can use in the gardens, it is called a pond liner. So let me just call this concrete version of it a liner. So yeah, it was a lot of work. I didn't expect that it would be so much work to do it. Like, I spent so much time, you know, adjusting, like making it all even. I obviously didn't include all the footage of it because this video would be so long. I only like showed you guys how I started to do it. And then I went on and lined all those, you know, islands, all the banks of the pond with this concrete liner. It is made of those mats walls we have in the game. Just as in the real, like in the habitat that was inspiration for this one, they also have something like this. It is to use so that the ponds and the islands will, you know, remain in the same shape, because normally the water would like gradually destroy them and they will change its shape. They will be smaller and smaller with the time, and to prevent that, the ponds are like lined with some material, for example concrete or something. So yeah, I wanted to make it here because, you know, many zoos do something like this with the ponds, with the water areas, and I thought that it would look super cool and also realistic. But it was so much work to do it right, because also I had to make sure that the terrain is almost at the same level as the lining, because otherwise it didn't look good. So yeah, trying to make this terrain even and not like going through this liner, and also making this liner in very like gentle curves, not in like, you know, harsh angles. It was a lot of work, but in the end I really love how it has turned out. And I hope you guys will like it, because let me just tell you that it was a lot of work, and right now I think that I can call myself a professional pond liner. Such a profession even exists, but I think that there are people who do it, so yeah, I can definitely go and start my own company that will specialize in pond lining. So if you need some pond to be lined, definitely call me, I will do it for you. So after being done with that, I focused on adding a lot of plants near the entrance to the habitat. I added mainly the elephant grass because I think that it looks very cool near the water areas in those more tropical desert and savanna biomes. So yeah, I added a lot of it here. The main like purpose of that is that the people actually, or the guests, won't be watching the flamingos from the, you know, wrong angle, from the wrong side, because it is not the place that they're meant to be looking at it. In the real build there's also a lot of those you know, higher grasses or higher some other plants. I mixed the elephant grass with some other plants to give it more like this overgrown, a bit dry feeling, like it's not so perfect in the perfect condition, because I think that, you know, it would be simply hard to keep the plants in this perfect condition, even though, you know, they would probably water them in here, because we are still in the desert, still in the desert biome. So, you know, some of them could be dry, some of them could be like dead from being too old or something. So yeah, obviously in this game we have all the plants in the perfect condition, because why would developers of this game, you know, give us plants that are dead or that are, you know, dry or something, that are not 100% healthy. But I like to, you know, give them some of this more realistic look of being not in this like super perfect condition. So I always add some, you know, those dry colors. The Spanish moss is actually very good for it. You just rotate it so it doesn't hang down. You just make some, you know, add some of them by each other and it creates this really nice dry plant. You can always add some bushes that are in this, you know, lighter color, and I think that in the end it looks really, really good. After that, I wanted to add some more like shallow areas in the water for the flamingos, because flamingos are known from, you know, going through this shallow water looking for food. It is really a typical behavior for them. They are looking for food like that. So yeah, they spend a lot of time in this shallow water looking for some, you know, seaweeds, algae, small fish, shrimps, and all other, you know, small creatures that they eat. So I wanted to give them those areas. And also I saw in some like other video by some other content creator, I unfortunately cannot remember who it was, but I remember that it is possible to put, you know, this enrichment thing for the flamingos, this like pool where they eat. It is possible to add it like in the actual water, but by the shore or by the bank. And then the keeper will still be able to fill it with food. So I did it just like that. I like added it just like very close to the you know, to the coast, to the shore of the water, and then the keeper is like perfectly fine with that. They don't complain. They feel it. I also hid it in the rocks. I added a lot of those aquatic plants to hide it. The flamingos are using it with no problem and it looks so cool. Like they actually, like you don't know if that there is a feeder there. It looks like they are like going there just to look for some food. And just as they would do in the real life. So yeah, it looks really cool. You will obviously be able to see it in the cinematic shots by the end of this video. So definitely stay tuned for that. And I really, really love this idea. In the you know, original build, they also have this more shallow water, so they can go through it and look for some food. And that's what I really, really wanted to make them make for them here. So we have two of them in each of the habitats, and I really, really love this idea. As you could see, I connected those islands with some logs, some dead trees. This is also something that I took from the original habitats. I think that the main purpose of that is that, you know, there are some birds like herons in those habitats that like to sit on those logs and watch the water. If there's some fish, then it just attacks the fish. But I also thought that it is a very, very cool detail and I wanted to include it in here. The flamingos, both in the game, they obviously don't use it, but in the real life I don't think they also would use it. But yeah, possibly if we if I decide to add any more birds in the future in here, it would make more sense. But still, I really like how it is looking, and potentially maybe if our keepers would be like better at, you know, climbing and going through such things, they could also use it to move from one island to another, but obviously they won't. Right now, as you can see, I am adding a lot of plants to this habitat. I really wanted to make it lush, but I also wanted to give them some trees. And in the original habitat, there is also some trees. I think that the main purpose of the trees is to provide the shade from the animals, because, you know, we are on the desert, so the shade is really, really important. The flamingos, they don't need shelter in such climates, I think. They don't have any in the zoo, but also they don't require any shelter in the game. So I put all the, you know, I actually didn't add the the hay bedding, but I also added the leaves that we got with the South America pack. And yeah, I added them like below the trees, and it looks really, really cool because they're actually sleeping under the trees, like in the shade, so it is working really, really fine. Yeah, I added a lot of new plants in here, those Africa plants. I also added a lot of those ponytail palm trees. I love to sink them down in the water so that they look like those, you know, grasses or those aquatic plants that they grow like near the banks of the water. And yeah, I really love the foliage in this habitat. I could go a bit more crazy with the foliage that I choose, like more crazy than in the Elm Hill City Zoo, because there we are mainly using the temperate plants, and here I am going a bit more crazy with tropical plants, and I love it. Finally, I can use them here, so I definitely use the opportunity. The flamingos are surprisingly really, really good with the traversable area in the game. I mean, they can traverse over the plants, the small rocks with no problems, because a lot of animals have problems with those small aquatic rocks, but the flamingos don't have any problem with them, so I was really, really happy about it because they have plenty of space in here. I added a lot of those rocks, and I also added some logs because in the original habitat there are also a lot of those logs and rocks, and I wanted to you know, recreate that, so those things often like make it hard for the animals to traverse, but the flamingos don't have any problems, so I was really, really happy about that. As you can see, the half of this episode has already passed and I am still focusing on the first habitat. This is because I didn't actually include the footage of the second habitat here in the video because it was simply too long. I didn't want to bore you guys because in the second habitat, I will basically do the same things. I will also, you know, add those feeders and submerge them in the water a bit. I will add the very similar foliage. I will also do those dead trees and branches like in the bit between the islands. So yeah, this will be basically the same thing. So I didn't want to make this video too long, and that's why I only included the footage of only one habitat in here, but you will be able to see it all in the cinematics by the end of this video. I included more this time actually, just to be sure that you guys will see those two habitats from every angle, and you know, we'll be able to see how I made those things. But yeah, if you are watching the first habitat, the second one will for sure be like understandable for you, and you will know what I did in there. So yeah, that's why I only included one in this video. I also forgot to mention about the fence around this habitat, so I choose the electric one and I made it really, really low. It is also a trick that I use and many other people use, that you know, you can actually make fences less than 1 meter. You just have to, like, you know, move the bottom part of it like under the ground and then you are able to just make the fence the height that you want. So those birds, when they have their feathers you know, and the wings clipped, just as zoos do, they often clip the feathers of you know, birds like flamingos, storks, pelicans, so that they won't be able to fly away. They are just able to, you know, walk and swim. The height of this fence, I'm sure that it would be enough. It is an electric fence. The game actually recognizes those fences as the escape opportunity for the animals, but I turned off the escaping in the sandbox mode options, because you can totally do that and then the birds are not able to escape, and also the fence just doesn't like interrupt the viewers, I mean the guests, the view, so it looks way more prettier, but still there is some fence so that the flamingos are unable to escape. So in the place where the three paths actually meet behind this habitat, we'll have our gate to the African village in this zoo. So as I told you guys, this whole zoo will be divided into different villages. We'll have, for example, African village, desert village, we'll have Asian village, and so on. And this one is the entrance to the African village, so we'll have a lot of African animals in there in the future. Those flamingos, they are like, you can meet them in many parts of the world actually, but they still live in Africa also. So yeah, they're the just perfect, you know, this introduction to our African part of the zoo. And yeah, in the future we'll focus more on the African animals. Also for on the animals from the Africa pack, like I made a little break from, you know, adding African animals from the new Africa pack to our videos. We'll have one of them or maybe two of them still in the Elm Hill City Zoo in the near future. So if you want to see it, definitely like watch my next video, because one of them will be in this video. As I told you guys, it will be probably out on Saturday. So now it is time for our fun facts. Today's fun facts are obviously about the greater flamingos. They are really interesting birds. They are actually the most widespread and the largest member of the flamingo family. There are 6 species of flamingo in the world, and they are the biggest ones, as I said. They have very attractive coloration. They have this pinkish white feathers with some of the feathers red and black on the wings. They have long pink bills with black tip, yellow eyes, and long pink legs. The male is actually bigger than the female, and the juveniles are gray-brown in coloration. They are living in Africa, the Middle East, Southern Europe, and India. As I told you, they are living next to the shallow water bodies such as lagoons, salt pans, large alkaline and saline lakes. Greater flamingos are very social. They travel in groups numbering up to thousands. They are partially migratory, which means that they are traveling constantly because they need to be able to find food for such a large flock of birds. So they are constantly looking for areas to sustain the whole like herd of them, because when they find one, after a while there is nothing else for them to eat, so they need to go and find another place. Greater flamingos can produce the loud goose-like sound called the honking. They are surprisingly good swimmers, but they prefer the shallow water. Flamingos can often be seen standing on one leg. It is thought that they want to keep the tucked up leg warm within their feathers. They stand on both legs during very hot days. And they are also able to sleep on one leg, so while they are sleeping, they are keeping one of their legs warm in their feathers. Their pink color comes from the carotenoid pigment present in the algae and crustaceans they eat. So they are not naturally pink, their color comes from the things that they eat, so the feathers are colored because of their food, and this is actually really, really interesting. And the word flamingo actually comes from the Latin flame, so they are called after the color that they are in. Some other species of flamingos are, you know, in those brighter colors, like more vivid colors. So I can totally see why they are called the way they are. You know, seeing like a large flock of those birds can really, you know, be reminiscent of a large fire or a flame. But actually other species of flamingo, like Chilean flamingo, are more, you know, brighter in color than greater flamingo. But still the color of that bird is amazing. Okay, that's all for our fun facts. Let me just tell you that at the end of this video, I will also add some of the viewing areas from the guests. I will do the things about, you know, some decorating around the habitats. The viewing areas for the guests will have some thatch roofs. I think that it will be very important in this zoo to give the guests a lot of shade, because it is basically on the desert, so we need to really focus on that. So you know, all the viewing areas will have some shade in here, some paths also will have some, and we'll add a lot of those things in here. At the end, I also would like to thank you guys, because I saw a thread on the Planet Zoo forums, I mean Frontier forums. There is a site, if you haven't visited, definitely go and do so, because there are a lot of very interesting information about the game. There's a lot of speculation, what's next for the game and so on. And lately there was a thread, someone asked who is your favorite content creator for, you know, gaining some inspiration for your zoos. And some of you actually, you know, said that it is me, or mentioned me. So thank you guys so much. I am so grateful. Thank you for, you know, spreading the word about me. It really means a lot to me, so thank you for that. And I am really happy that you know, my builds are inspiring, and that you are willing to share that with other people. Yeah, this is amazing. So thank you if you are watching it and you actually said my name. I'm, as I told you, super grateful, and you are simply the best. Okay guys, this is all that I have for you today. Please enjoy the rest of this speed build and stay till the end for the cinematic shots. I hope that you have enjoyed our Flamingo Islands, and if you have, please consider to subscribe. If you are a subscriber, thank you so much, and if not, definitely click that subscribe button if you want to see me build more of those realistic and detailed habitats. If you enjoyed this video, definitely give it a big thumbs up down below. Ring the bell if you want to be notified every time I upload a new video. And comment down below if you liked the video, or if you have any recommendations for my future videos. Those are very welcome. Thank you guys for watching. Have a wonderful day, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye guys!